Porcelain lizards? They look new. Out of place with the rest of this old beat-up stuff.
What's being pointed to this? Aha! Check the house first. That's the rules.
Are you prepared to suffer to save your son? You have 5 minutes to cut off the last section of one of your fingers in front of the camera. If you succeed, you will get your reward. Try this again.
You have 4 minutes and 30 seconds left.
Thank you. That's affirmative, Lieutenant. We're in position.
Perfect. Nobody moves until I give this signal. Is that clear? We nail him as soon as he sets foot outside.
Right, Lieutenant.
Lucky that patrol spotted his car.
What's he doing in there?
Beats me. You're the profiler, right? I thought you were supposed to be right inside the killer's head.
That's just it. What I know of Ethan Mars doesn't match the killer's psychological profile.
I know what the jury's gonna choose between your theories and concrete proof. What the fuck is that girl doing there? If Mars comes out now, she's gonna be in trouble.
What do we do, Lieutenant? Wanna get her out?
No, stand down. Going inside. Maybe she lives there. Us just as well. We don't want anyone hanging around if Mars comes out.
Ethan, what happened? The police. They're out there. I think they're here to arrest you. We've got to find another way out.
Shit. What's he up to in there? Wait for a go on my word. Ready on my go. Stay here, Jaden.
Out of the question. I'm coming with you.
Two men at the door, hold your positions. It's a go.
Come on, let's go this way.
Downstairs, they're in the alley. Follow them.
The subway.
Ah.
We've got to keep going. Ethan! Ethan, they're coming!
Less than an hour ago, we heard from the police who have identified the man thought to be the Origami Killer. Ethan Mars, father of the kidnapped victim Sean Mars, is on the run and should be considered armed and dangerous. A police manhunt is now underway, and they hope that they will soon be able to announce the apprehension of this dangerous lunatic.
I brought some food. I didn't know what you liked, so I brought some of everything. I hope that's okay.
You followed me.
I wanted to know. You're all over the news reports, Ethan. Every cop in the country will be hunting you. They say you're the Origami Killer. Is it true? Are you the killer, Ethan?
I sometimes have these blackouts. Times where I don't know what I'm doing. As if I'm someone completely different. The only thing I remember afterwards is the bodies. The bodies in the water.
Why are you hurt, Ethan? Why were you in that apartment?
I think my other self is testing my love for Sean. He wants to know if I'd love my son enough to save him. That means there's some part of me that knows where Sean is. But the only way to find him is to go through these trials.
Why can't you tell that to the police?
And tell them what? That I'm a schizophrenic who drowns his victims and has kidnapped his own son? They'd never let me go, and I have to stay free to save Sean. I have no choice. I'm his only chance. When Sean is out of danger, I'll turn myself in, but not until then.
You can't keep going like this. You're destroying yourself, Ethan.
Finding Sean is the only thing that matters.
There has to be another way.
You don't understand. Time is running out. Sean will be dead in a few hours. I have no choice!
Please, Madison, leave. Forget everything that's happened. There is nothing more you can do for me. If you want to help me, leave. Leave me to do this on my own.
Motherfucker's dead.
Your vodka, sir.
Thanks.
You look preoccupied, if you don't mind my saying so. Problems with the investigation?
Blake is convinced that Mars is the killer.
Not you. I thought there was some evidence to that effect.
That's true. But it just doesn't make sense. His psychological profile doesn't fit. Neither does the geolocalization. I can't see this father drowning 8 victims before kidnapping his own kid. Mars is not the Aragami killer. I'd stake my life on it.
Then who is?
I haven't the faintest fucking idea.
Maybe you should review the evidence in your possession.
That's just what I was thinking of doing.
Oh, one last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you-know-what. It can be dangerous. Very dangerous.
I'm trying to keep a handle on it, but that's difficult. It gets more and more difficult.
It'll end up killing you if you're not careful. That would be most unfortunate, sir.
Well, well. Looks like there's something new. The video recording from near the park on the afternoon Sean Mars disappeared. I doubt there's anything on it, but you never know.
How the fuck do I watch it?
A Chevrolet model corresponding to the tire prints passed at 1602 heading for the park, when in the opposite direction at 1637. That could fit the time that Sean Mars disappeared. Could it be the killer's car? Pity we can't see the driver's face. The car was stolen. Let's see, a certain Jackson Neville was suspected of stealing it, but the charges were dropped. Not enough evidence. Jackson Neville, a.k.a. Mad Jack, involved in several cases of buying and selling stolen vehicles. Considered to be very dangerous. This guy might have provided the killer with a car. It's a pretty slim lead, but it's all I have right now.
One last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in your wine. It can be dangerous. Very dangerous.
Shit. It's coming. Tryptocaine. The tube is on the bedside table. All I need is to take some, and the pain will go away. I should resist. This is gonna kill me. I know I can resist. I just need to stay in control and do something until it goes away.
Manfred! Manfred! Anybody home? Hi there, Manfred.
Who is it?
Scott. Scott Shelby. Do you remember me?
Scott? Scott! Oh, yes, of course. Well, good to see you. How long has it been?
Oh, about 10 years, I guess.
Oh, at my age, time means nothing anymore. I repair clocks, but I try to forget about time. How about you? Are you still with the police?
Oh, no, I quit. I'm a private investigator now. This is Lauren. She's a friend.
Hello.
Oh, hello, young lady. Well, this calls for a celebration. I've just the thing. Wait there. I'm sure I saw a bottle of scotch around here somewhere. Do an old man a favor, would you, Scott? Tell him to call back this afternoon.
Sure, no problem. Hello? Yeah, this is Manfred's. He's not available right now. Could you call back later this afternoon? Thanks.
Well, to old friends.
I'd like you to have a look at an envelope. I thought maybe you could tell me about the typewriter that was used to type the address on it.
Well, let's have a look. Could you pass me the magnifying glass from behind the counter?
Oh, sure,
please?
I'll get it.
My eyes are beginning to fail me. Thanks. Well, let's see what this envelope has to say for itself. The Royal Five. Yes, the shape of the T's and the F's is typical of that model. Produced between 1907 and 1924. Yes. No doubt about it. It's a Royal Five.
Are there many places around that could repair one of these?
I bought the company's entire stock of spare parts for a song in 64. Well, they were going to take them to the dumpster, so I got the lot. Well, anybody around here who has one that actually works has been to see me at one time or another.
Do you keep a record of all your clients?
Oh, yes, indeed. At least the ones who pay.
Any chance I could get a peek at that?
Yes, of course. I keep my account books in the office. If you're not in a hurry, I have a list of all the clients who ever bought a Royal Five or had one repaired.
Yeah, that would really help us out.
Delighted to help. Give me 2 minutes, and I'll be right back with the list.
You think the killer's been here?
If he has a 1920s typewriter, he may have needed Manfred's services to get it fixed. We'll know when we get the list. Manfred.
Hello? Your call is locked, sir. A police car will be there in a few minutes. I need to know who you are, sir. Sir? Hello?
Oh, my God. He's dead. Oh.
Oh, my God.
What are you doing?
I'm calling the police.
The killer has already called the police. I think he wants us to be his scapegoats. We gotta get the hell out of here.
What do you mean? We have nothing to do with his death. We were just here when it happened.
Look, we're running out of time to find Sean Mars. The last thing we need is 24 hours in a police station explaining this whole thing.
Well, so what do we do?
Watch the front door. I'll get rid of our fingerprints from everything we touched since we came in. We better work fast. The police are going to be here any minute. What are you doing, Lauren? If someone comes in, we're going to be in trouble.
These are Manfred's account books. He must have been looking for owners of Royals when he was killed.
Forget it. We gotta get out of here fast.
Longer? The police will be here any second.
I'm almost finished. That's it. We're done.
You get all the prints?
I got what I got. It should be enough to prevent them from finding us. Come on, let's go.
So, you claim the victim was killed while you were in his shop.
Yes, he went to get something in his office. A few minutes later, I went in to see if he was okay. That's when I found him.
You should have called the police immediately, Mr. Shelby. Would have saved us dragging your ass down here.
Listen, we had nothing to do with this murder. We were only there by coincidence. I just wanted to spare myself a few hours declaring I didn't see anything to a police officer.
P.I. or not, Mr. Shelby, don't leave town. And if you end up next door to any more dead bodies, remember to call us. Okay?
Thanks, Carter. I owe you one.
You on to anything at the moment?
Well, I got some ideas. Nothing concrete.
Well, if it goes beyond the idea stage, you tell me about it, will you, Scott?
Sure. Taking you home. This is getting way too dangerous.
No way. We're partners, remember? We had a deal.
The deal's off. I changed the rules. Whether you like it or not, you're going home. And I don't want to talk about it. That's it.
I'm not a child. I know what I have to do. I've got to find my sense of flow. You're not going to stop me.
You're gonna be a good girl, you're gonna go home, and let me get on with my investigation.
Stop the car. Stop the fucking car!
I have no choice. I guess I'm doing this to protect her. This girl's stubborn as a mule. She doesn't let up, with or without me. It's all my fault. I should never have let her come with me. Lauren!
Him once again in my arms.
Thank you.
What do you want?
Oh, fuck it.
I said 1,000 times that I don't want any junkies at my door. Hey! Take it easy, man, huh? Keep cool.
What do you want?
Dope?
Money?
Tell me what you need. Sure we can make a deal, huh?
God, I'm gonna blow your brains out, you son of a bitch! You think you're coming to my house to steal my dope? You'll be shooting up in hell, motherfucker!
Will you stop fucking moving? Man, I give you whatever you want. Got dope? I got cash? You want some dope? Please. Please don't kill me, man. I got children. These are my girls, see? This one's Sarah. And the little one. That's Cindy. Please, man. I want to see them again. Please, please don't shoot.
I'm a father too, but I have no choice.
Matt, it's Sam. I got your information. The owner of the apartment in Marble Street is a Dr. Adrian Baker. He's a struck-off surgeon. He used to sell drugs to junkies on the quad. He made some cash and bought up some cheap-ass apartments, including the one in Marble Street. Of course, he got caught. He did a few months in prison and was struck off the medical register.
Interesting. Thanks for the information, Sam. I owe you one.
Hey, Matt, be careful, okay?
I'm on it. Talk to you later. The owner of the apartment where Ethan cut off his finger lives here. It's not much of a lead, but it's all I've got. Hi. I was told that you could get Bitropin. Without a prescription.
Sorry, you were misinformed. Goodbye.
Hold on. I really need your help here. I can pay.
Well, why didn't you say so? Please come in.
So, you're looking for Bitropin, my dear. Are you having trouble sleeping? How much do you need?
I don't know, about 3-4 boxes.
Well, no, that shouldn't be a problem. Would you like a drink? I was just about to have one.
No, thanks.
Well, alcohol helps take the edge off the pills, don't you think? Anyway, we should drink a toast to our first deal. I haven't seen you around here before. Who told you about me?
I met a guy at a party. He popped some Bitropin. Told me he got it from you. I heard you had some apartments for rent. I'm looking.
Sorry, darling. Those are all booked up.
Shame. I was looking for something around Marble Street.
You're not drinking?
Yeah, sure I am.
Having some trouble? Didn't your mother ever warn you about accepting gifts from strangers?
He drank it. For fuck.
Say hello to Matthew. He claimed he had come to the census. Another one of those goddamn government spies. So, you're interested in my Marble Street apartment. I rent it to my friend Paco, if you must know. I have no idea what he does there. Maybe that's where he fornicates with his dancers from the Blue Lagoon. To be honest, I don't give a damn, because as long as he pays his rent, he can do whatever he likes. But enough with the chit-chat. I miss surgery, you see, so I take every opportunity to practice. I don't have any instruments here, so I use whatever comes to hand. I hope you won't hold that against me. Hold on. Is my stinger. Have you ever noticed? As soon as you start to do a little housework, someone always comes calling. I'll get rid of our visitor and be right back. Don't move. I won't be long.
Can you stop that thing? Norman Jaden, FBI. Can we talk for a minute?
I'm listening.
Can we go inside? I'm looking for the owner of a blue Chevrolet Malibu 83. I don't give a damn how the car got here, whether you stole it or not. I just want to know who bought it from you.
Sorry, man. Don't ring a bell. I got a real bad memory of names.
Perhaps I can help you to remember. If we find out that you sold the car to the man we're looking for, you're looking at some pretty solid time inside, Jackie boy.
You trying to scare me with your big talk? I never saw your damn car. Now take a walk.
Blood. Now why is there blood here?
On your head, pig. I ain't got time to be playing around with you. Let's just get you out of sight and finish you off.
You're gonna tell me about the man with the blue car.
Go fuck yourself in the ass.
What?
Broke my fucking nose, pig.
Next, I'm gonna blow a hole in your face. Spill all of it.
You will scare me, Mr. CSI. You ain't got it in you.
Do you like fireworks, Jack? Because I bet them gas tanks are gonna blow up real nice.
Shit, man, don't mess with the gasoline.
Well, just say it was an accident. Or rather, I'll say it was an accident because you won't really be able to talk, will you, Jack?
You crazy motherfucker. You out of your mind, man? No, I don't know nothing about the guy. He wanted me to get rid of his dirty car, get him a new one with false plates. He paid cash, and I ain't the questioning kind. Said I was supposed to drop the word to a guy named Paco down at the Blue Lagoon when the car was done. Now that's all I know.
We'll continue this discussion down at the station. You're under arrest. You have the right to remain silent. Anything... Shit, not now. Anything you say can and will be...
Hey. You look like you got a problem, man.
What? They letting you dope heads in the FBI now? God bless America. Now I'm gonna give you a little help with your drug problem, Mr. 5-0. Permanently.
So, you think the origami killer killed Manfred?
That makes sense. Didn't want him spilling his guts to us.
And you suspect Gordy Kramer, right?
Oh, him or one of his men. Gordy has the time and the means, not to mention the fucked up attitude to go along with it. He's only a suspect, but he's a pretty guilty looking one.
Are these your files on the case?
Yeah, I've been working on them for a couple years. I built up a mountain of paperwork.
Magazines about origami? You think the killer could have subscribed to one of those?
If he was even remotely interested in origami in the last 30 years, his name may be in there somewhere. Trouble is, there's over 500 names. It gets a squat.
I'm starving. Do you have anything to eat?
Well, I'm no chef, but I should be able to make some scrambled eggs if you like.
Great. I'm soaking wet. I need to warm up a little. Is it okay if I take a shower?
I'll be my guest. Go to my bedroom. It's the next door. Oh, I'll cook up the eggs while you're under the shower.
Egg should be ready by now.
It like scrambled it all.
I took the liberty of borrowing your bathrobe.
Looks better on you.
Hey, that almost looks good enough to eat.
What's that?
The notebook I took from Manfred's place. According to this, about 30 clients bought spare parts for Royal Machines in the last 10 years. The killer may be one of them.
Oh, you know, checking out the alibi of 30 clients, one by one, that's a lot of legwork.
Except that if we cross-check them with the list... The list of subscribers to Origami magazines. You still got that, right?
Yeah, of course. But Lauren, wait.
Eat those eggs I made, bitch.
If the killer really used a Royal typewriter, and if he subscribed to an Origami magazine, his name should be on both lists.
Well, Lauren, I mean, that's just an assumption, but... Yeah, I suppose...
His name is here somewhere. Help me. We're gonna find him.
The only guy whose name is on both lists died when he was 10. What are you gonna do now? Dig up his coffin, make sure he's dead?
I know it doesn't make any sense. Unless the killer was only using his name.
But why use the name of a kid who died 30 years ago?
Well, that's what we came to find out. The name is John Shepherd. It should be on a grave around here somewhere.
You never give up, do you?
Excuse me. I'm looking for the grave of a young boy who died about 30 years ago. His name was John Shepherd. You wouldn't know where it is by any chance.
The children's graves are in the next plot.
Thanks.
origami figures.
That's one hell of a coincidence.
These flowers are fresh. Looks like someone's still tending the grave.
Oh, youngin. That one I knew well.
You knew John Shepherd?
I've worked this graveyard nearly all my life. I remember what happened. It was in 77, October, I think.
Yeah, good for nothing, hoodlums. Get the hell out of here! God, beat it, you lousy, no-good brats! Come back when you fucking mother comes home from work.
He's drunk again.
What are we gonna do? It's pouring rain. We're gonna get soaked if we spend a day outside.
Well, at least you won't get beat. Little rain never hurt nobody. Come on, let's go play. Bet you can't catch me!
Are you fucking kidding?
Come on! Jeez, you're enough. What are you doing? You're coming or not?
Thank you.
to do this. It's too hard for you.
No chance. I can do it all right. Just watch.
Seek. You go and count to 20 and try to find me, okay?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, 10, 14, 19, 20.
Kid never did find any help. Yet his brother drowned in a pipe full of rainwater.
The boy that lived, what happened to him?
Well, all I know is he got separated from his parents. I think he got adopted. Well, looks like a storm's coming. I guess I better be getting home.
Christ, what a horrible story. John Shepherd drowned in the rain while holding his brother's hand. Do you think he could be the origami killer?
Come on, let's get back in the car.
Wait.
What's the matter?
That man over there.
Yeah?
It's Charles Kramer.
Gordy's father? What's he doing here?
He's putting flowers on John Shepherd's grave.
looks like a flat shirt class. He hasn't even looked my way.
Time to play the sexy girl.
Less lesbian. Looks the exact same.
Guests only.
hard when she's ugly. Well, that's all it'll let me do, so that has to be it. Oh, he's creeping me good. Oh shit!
Before I get into big trouble. Everything's gonna be alright. Everything is going to be alright.
So, welcome to my little kingdom. I'll take her. Just get in the way of good things, sweet cheeks. So, show me what you can do. Take it all. Slowly. Take it all off.
Could I have a drink? You know, just a little drink to break the ice?
No, we already broke the ice. Let's get wet. Come on. Do your thing, girl.
Uh,
Could we just talk first?
No, no. We don't need any more talking. I all talked out. Now, show me what you can do.
I'm sorry. I think there's been a little misunderstanding. I'll just go. No harm done. Another time.
I think it is you who are misunderstood, honey. I'm tired of wasting my time. It's now or never, baby. I never take never for an answer.
The lamp. If only I could find some way to grab it. Oh, I know! Go, girl. Okay, act two. Let's hear Lover Boy sing. If you call out, I'll kill you. Got it?
Shit. What you want?
You rent an apartment on Marble Street. I want to know why.
An apartment? I don't know what you're talking about. Not bad for a chica, but you only hurt my feelings a little bit, mama. You fucking bitch! I'm gonna kill you!
Boss? Is everything all right?
Even he's impressed.
If you value those prized balls of yours, Paco, then it's time for you to talk.
What you doing? Stop it! Stop it!
I'm only getting started. How about some more?
I never set foot in that apartment. I gave the keys to some guy. He said he needed a place. He had money.
What was that guy's name?
I don't know his name, I swear! Shepard! His name is John Shepard, that's all I know, I swear it!
There, that wasn't so hard, was it? I really appreciated this romantic moment, but I gotta dash. See you next time, lover boy. Time to get out of here. I've got a massive headache.
I'm here to see Paco.
Paco? There ain't no Paco here, fella. Get lost.
Are you absolutely certain?
He's in his office. Take the stairs over there.
I gotta stop here. I gotta do stuff.